Good morning, everyone. We're continuing here in the Mesillas, Yesharim. And today, Be'ez Hashem, we shall conclude chapter 25, which is the second to the last chapter in all of Mesillas, Yesharim. And the Ramchal writes, as we are trying to create an awareness for ourselves that HaKadosh Baruch Hu is watching over us at all times. This means that a person has to think about this and delve into the matter constantly. B'shiftoi, when he sits. B'lechtoi, when he walks. B'shachcho, when he's lying down to go to sleep. U'b'kuma, when he's waking up in the morning. Right, this is the pasuk. This is based on the pasuk in the Shema. U'b'lechtocha v'derech, when a person is walking along the way, when they're sitting in their house, when they're lying down to sleep, when they're waking up. A person has to have an awareness all of the time that HaKadosh Baruch Hu is there. Ad sheyikba bedaito amitas hadavar. He thinks about it so much until finally becomes affixed in his mind that this is the truth and this is reality. Dehainu amitas himotzei shechinasa yizbarach b'chol makom. That the truth of the matter is that the Shechina, which is the Divine Presence, is literally everywhere. And we are literally standing in His presence before Him every single moment. Then you will come to fear HaKadosh Baruch Hu in truth. So once again, the Ramchal explains to us that this is not something that is natural, where you're just going to wake up in the morning and decide to fear Hashem. Like the Ramchal said much earlier in the Sefer Mesillas Yesharim, he said that all areas of Avodas Hashem, serving HaKadosh Baruch Hu, it's not like the natural forces and desires that a person has. A person is tired, they go to sleep. A person is hungry, so they eat. A person has slept enough, so they wake up, they have energy. It doesn't work like that in Ruchnius. It's not like I have this desire inside to fear HaKadosh Baruch Hu, to love Hashem, to have emunah. All of these things, the way that Hashem made it is, you must work and work and work to acquire it in order that it's meaningful and that it will be enmeshed in your spiritual psyche, in your spiritual DNA. It's something that a person must work on day after day and will have ups and downs. There will be times in our life where the presence of Hashem will feel very strong and will be very real. There'll be times when we're going through difficulties and a person begins to waver in their amunah and we start questioning where exactly is HaKadosh Baruch Hu during this time. But as a person, like the Ramchal writes, will make it his point that when he's walking, sleeping, getting up, and sitting in his place, he's always contemplating HaKadosh Baruch Hu, recognizing that he's sitting before the Shekhinah, realizing that Hashem in fact does see and he hears, and he knows everything that's going on. So then, in any situation that I find myself in, anywhere that I will go, whatever it is that I am doing, a person will come as Yira Oisei Be'emes, come to a true fear of HaKadosh Baruch Hu, which of course will lead us to that fear of sin, which the Ramchal is describing. King David, the great King David, who was certainly very well versed in the realms of Yiras Shamayim and Yiras Chet, but he was mispalah, he davened for it, and he said, Hoireini Hashem Darkecha, please Hashem, teach me your ways. Why? Because Ahalech Bamitecha, then I will be able to go in your truth. Yacha Levavi LeYiras Shemecha, and you should dedicate my heart to fear your name, which means that even the great Dovid HaMelech is saying, I need your help, Ribbono Shel'olam. It's not something that I could do by myself and accomplish on my own. I want to be a person of real yira, real fear that exists in my heart. And the only way that I can do it is I'm mispalil, I daven to you that you should show me the way and teach me how to do it. Which means that if King David, the great and the lofty Melech Yisrael, the king of Klal Yisrael, who wrote the Sefer Tehillim, whose whole life was a dedication to Acha Shalti Meis Hashem Oisa Vakesh, all the days of my life, there's only one thing that I want, says David HaMelech, and that is to shifty beveis Hashem, sit in the house of Hashem, wherever David HaMelech went, whether he was in the Beis Midrash, whether he was in Shul, whether he was in the palace, whether he was walking down the street, wherever he went, it was Beis Hashem. He was literally dwelling and living in the house of God. And yet David HaMelech writes, teach me Hashem. Teach me how to come to a level of fear, because on my own, I'm being inadequate. I won't be able to accomplish. If that's David HaMelech, al achas kama v'kama, all the more so, do we need to dedicate the proper time and the energy and the focus and concentration so that we too should be zeich, we should merit to be able to be called Yirei Hashem and Yirei Chet, those people who fear the presence of Hashem. They live in the awesomeness and the awe of the Rivayna Sha'ilam, and from that leads us to this higher level of Yiras Chet, where we fear to do sin, because we know how detrimental it is to ourselves, to the world around us, and most importantly, to our relationship with HaKadosh Baruch Hu. Have a wonderful day.